Hi, welcome to my 23rd video on calculus in the playlist of UPSC Max optional. So in the last video I have been solving the problem based on increasing and decreasing functions. So in the last video I have solved the 5th problem and the 6th problem. So you please try the 11th problem. So you just follow the same pattern which I did for 5th problem and the 6th problem. Now I'm going to solve the 8th problem, which is show that b minus u by 1 plus b square is less than tan inverse b minus tan inverse u is less than b minus u by 1 plus u square. So this is a very important problem. It's asked many times in many competitive exams. So you please watch this video very carefully. So I'm going to prove that b minus u by 1 plus b square is less than tan inverse u minus tan inverse v minus tan inverse u is less than 1 plus u square. This u square. So for this, it's a very tricky problem. So now you first take f of x as tan inverse u. I'll explain why you want to take tan. Why you want to take f of x as tan inverse u, tan inverse x. So this will be you take f of x as tan inverse x, and you take the value of x in between u and v. So the value of x lies between u and v. Now f of x is tan inverse x. Now we find f dash of x. So we know the derivative of tan x is 1 by 1 plus x square. Now we have already discussed the Lagrange mean value theorem, that is f must be continuous on closed interval a, b. F must be differentiable on open interval a, b. If these two conditions are satisfied, then there exists a point in open interval a, b such that f dash of c is equal to f of b minus f of a by b minus a. So this is the Rolle's theorem. This is the Lagrange's mean value theorem. Now you see that this f is continuous on u to v, and f dash of x also exists. So by Lagrange mean value theorem, there exists c. So by Lagrange theorem, there exists c belongs to u comma v such that. I'm just applying the theorem here. So this will be f dash of c is equal to f of v minus f of u by v minus u. So I'm just replacing a and b as u comma v. Now f of v, we have taken f of x as tan inverse x. So f of v will be, so f dash of c is 1 by 1 plus c square. F of b is tan inverse b, f of u is tan inverse u by b minus u, right? Now you take this equation as, let us say it is char. So we have 1 by this c square c square. So I'm just replacing f dash of x as f dash of c. Now there exists c belongs to open interval u comma v. So c lies in between, somewhere between u and v. So it is clear that this u will always be less than c, right? Now there exists c in open interval u comma v such that f of b minus f of u by b minus u is equal to f dash of c. So we have u is less than c. Because c lies, here it is u, it is v. C lies somewhere between u and v. So this value will always be less than this value. So we have u is always less than v. So u always less than v. This implies u square is always less than c square. So this implies I'm just adding 1 to both sides. So this will be 1 plus u square is always less than 1 plus c square. So if we take reciprocal, 1 by 1 plus u square will be greater than 1 by 1 plus c square. So this implies 1 by 1 plus c square is always less than 1 by 1 plus u square. Right? Now from star we have tan inverse v minus tan inverse u by v minus u is equal to 1 by 1 plus c square. So this is less than 1 by 1 plus u square. 1 by 1 plus u square. So I am just taking v minus u to this side. So here I have tan inverse v minus tan inverse u by v minus u. So this means tan inverse v minus tan inverse u is less than v minus u by 1 plus u square. So we have proved the first part, which is tan inverse u minus tan inverse v is less than v minus u by 1 plus u square. So for proving this part, we have considered the first case, which is u is always less than c. Now, for the second part, this c, now since c lies between u and v, so for proving the first part, we have taken u is less than c. For second part, we are going to take c is less than b. So for, we consider this c is less than b, and then we are going to follow the same technique. Now it is clear that this c is always less than b, because there exists c in open interval u comma b. So because c belongs to open interval u comma b, so this means c is always less than b. So we are going to follow the same pattern. So c square is less than v square. So this means 1 plus c square is less than 1 plus v square. So this means 1 by 1 plus c square is greater than 1 by 1 plus v square. So this means 1 by 1 plus v square is less than 1 by 1 plus v square. So from star we have tan inverse b minus tan inverse u by v minus u is equal to 1 by 1 plus c square. So this is greater than 1 by 1 plus v square. You bring v minus u to this side. So we have left with tan inverse b minus tan inverse u is greater than v minus u by 1 plus v square. So this means v minus u by 1 plus v square is less than tan inverse u minus tan inverse u minus tan inverse v. So take this as equation 2. Now you take this as equation 1. So from 1 and 2 it is clear that from 1 and 2 we have v minus u is less than 1 plus b square is less than tan inverse u minus tan inverse v, and this is less than v minus u by 1 plus u square. So this is the result we want to prove. So v minus u by 1 plus v square is less than tan inverse u, and this is less than v minus u by 1 plus b square. So this is less than v minus u by 1 plus b square, 1 plus u square. So that's it. It's an important, very important sum. Now, in the question, it is also asked that deduce that 5 by 4 is less than 3 by 25 is less than tan inverse 4 by 3 is less than 5 by 4 plus 1 by 6. So for this we have tan inverse 4 by 3. So in here we don't have here this term. So I'm taking u to be 4 by 3 and b to be 4 by 3. Sorry, this is tan inverse b minus tan inverse u. Sorry, I made a mistake in the question, because we have proved tan inverse b minus tan inverse u, right? Yes, tan inverse b minus tan inverse u. So change this question to tan inverse b minus tan inverse u. So I'm taking b to be 4 by 3 and there is no u term here, so I'm taking u to be 0. So I'm taking b to be, so for deduction, now you take b to be 4 by 3 and u to be 0. So we have b minus u by 1 plus b square is less than tan inverse b minus tan inverse u is less than b minus u by 1 plus u square. So if you take b to be 4 by 3, I have 4 by 3 minus 0 by 1 plus 4 by 3 square, which is 16 by 9. So this is less than tan inverse 4 by 3 minus tan inverse 0. Tan inverse 0 is 0. Sorry, tan inverse you take u to be 1, u to be 1. So you tan inverse 1 is less than b minus u. So 4 by 3 minus 0 by 1 plus 16 by 9. Sorry, this is u. 1 plus u square, which is 1. So we have this term will be 4 by 3. This term will be 9 plus 16. So 25 by 9. This is less than tan inverse 4 by 3. And tan inverse 1. Tan inverse 1 is pi by 4. This is less than 4 by 3 by 2. So take pi by 4 to both the side. So we have to come here with the answer. So this will be, this if we bring this to numerator, this term will be 3 by 25 plus pi by 4. This is less than tan inverse 4 by 3. So if you bring this to numerator, it will be 8. It will be 1 by 6, because 4 by 3 into 2 by 1. Sorry, 2 by 1, 1 by 2. This will be 4 by 6. 1 by 6. B minus u, 4 by 3 minus 1. This is 4 by 3 minus 1. Here also it is 1 here, plus b minus u. This will be 1. This will be 1. So in the numerator I have 4 by 3 minus 1. So this will be 4 minus 3 by 3, which is 1 by 3. Here I have 1 by 3. So we bring this to numerator, it will be 1 by 6. This will be 3 by 25 plus pi by 4. So this is the result we want to prove, that 3 by 25 plus pi by 4 is less than tan inverse 4 by 3 is less than 1 by 6 plus pi by 4. This is a deduction. So pi by 4 plus 3 by 25 is less than tan inverse 4 by 3 is less than pi by 4 plus 1 by 6. So that's it. It's a very important sum. You please go through once again. So we have completed almost 3 problems on functions, increasing and decreasing functions. So I'll just give the hint for the 11th problem, that is, so I'll just give the hint for the 11th problem. So you please watch the previous video, so that if you have watched the previous video, you can solve the 11th problem in your own. So 11th problem. So this is the 11th problem. So I'll just give the hint. Now for the first part, you take f of x. For the first part, you take f of x to be log 1 plus x by 1 minus x minus 2x. Now you find f dash of x. So f dash of x will be, f dash of x will be, now we want to differentiate log 1 plus x by 1 minus x. So it's a lengthy process. So this will be 1 by 1 plus x by 1 minus x. And then you want to differentiate inside d by dx of 1 plus x by 1 minus x minus 2. So this will be 1 minus x by 1 plus x. And the very important part is this x belongs to open interval 0 comma 1. Now you take this as v, and then you apply the formula v u dash minus u v dash by v square. So we'll get one term here minus 2. Now you check whether it is an increasing function. You check whether it will be an increasing function. So this means f dash of x is greater than 0. So this means it is an increasing function. So this means f is increasing function. I'm following the same technique which I did in the previous video. Now you find f of 0. So f of 0 will be log 1 plus 0 by 1 minus 0 minus 2 into 0, which is 0. Now since an increasing function, we have f of x is always greater than f of 0. Right? Now what is f of x? F of x, we have taken f of x as log 1 plus x by 1 minus x is greater than f of 0 is 0 minus 2x. Minus 2x is greater than 0. So this will be log 1 plus x by 1 minus x is greater than 2x. So this means 2x is always less than log 1 plus x by 1 minus x. So we have proved the first part, and for the second part you take f of x to be 2x into 1 plus 1 by 3 x square by 1 minus x square minus log 1 plus x by 1 minus x. So you please watch the previous video. I'm sure that you will be do it in your own. For second part, you take f of x to be, I write here, f of x to be this whole term minus log 1 plus x by 1 minus x. And then you find f dash of x. You show it is an increasing function. Now you find f of 0. And then since it's increasing function, capital F of, you take this as capital F of x. So this means capital F of x greater than f of 0. Now you apply f of x here. You change this term to 0. So you apply f of x here. And then you change, you keep log 1 plus x by 1 minus x. And then you take the remaining part to this side. Now you have arrived at the result. So you mark this equation as 1. You mark this equation as 2. So from 1 and 2, it is clear that 2x is less than log 1 plus x by 1 minus x is less than 2x into 1 plus x square by 3 into 1 minus x square. It's a very easy problem. So since you have watched the 4 sums in this method, I'm sure that you can solve a problem in your own. So in the next video, we will continue solving the problem based on increasing and decreasing functions. So I have solved the 5th problem, 6th problem, and 8th problem and 11th problem. So 10th problem and 12th problem more or alike the same. So in the next video, we will solve 9, 10, 12, and then we'll move on to the next topic, which is Taylor's theorem. So hope you enjoyed this video. So we'll see in the next video. Goodbye. Thank you.